Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the multicollinearity VIF, variance influence factor. So today topics are: what is multicollinearity, problem with having multicollinearity, what causes multicollinearity, Pearson correlation, and how do we detect multicollinearity and how to remove it. So what is multicollinearity? So multicollinearity means independent variables are highly correlated to each other in a regression model. So in regression analysis, it is an important assumption that the regression model should not be faced with the problem of multicollinearity. So the problem with having multicollinearity is, if there are the two independent variables are highly correlated, it's difficult to tell which variable affects the different variable. So the example for this statement is, so they are the age and years of experience, they are the two independent variables, and the salary is the dependent variable. So these two independent variables are depends on the salary variable. So here, if you suppose to age is increasing, then years of experience also be increasing. So from this statement, from this table, you can observe that, so these two features, age and years of experience, are highly correlated. Why? Because if age is increasing, then years of experience is also be increasing. But it's difficult to tell which variable, which means either age or experience affect the different variable salary. So multicollinearity can be a problem in regression model because we would not be able to distinguish between the individual effects of the independent variables, age or experience, on the different variable salary. For example, let's assume the linear equation like y is equal to mx plus b. So there are the here two features, that's why I am taking the W1, W2, these are the two coefficients. W0 is my intercept and X1, X2 is my independent variables and Y is my target variable. Suppose here these two independent variables are highly correlated, like age and years of experience, so these two variables are highly correlated. So then the effect of X1, like age, X1 be considered as age, X2 be considered as a experience. So the effect of age on Y is hard to distinguish from the effect of years of experience on salary, because any increasing in age, which is also be an associated with increasing in X2 also, which means if age is increasing, then years of experience also be increasing. So that's why it is very distinguished. It is very difficult to identify which input variable is affects on the dependent variable. So when the multicollinearity is not a problem, so if your goal is to predict the target variable Y, like salary, from this set of independent variables X1, X2, like age and experience, years of experience, so then multicollinearity is not a problem in regression analysis. Why? Because if multicollinearity may not be effect on the accuracy of the model, but we might lose some reliability of the determining the effect of the individual features on your model. The predictions will still be accurate, and overall R square quantifies how well the model predicts the Y value. Here R square is the one of the evaluation metrics for the regression model. So in lecture number 3, I was clearly explaining about the how to calculate the R-square value with mathematically and through coding also. So what causes multicollinearity? So multicollinearity could occur due to some problems. So what kind of the problems? So multicollinearity could also occur when new variable is created which are dependent on the other variables. So if you see this example, actually here Age is one independent variable, years of experience another independent variable. So these two variables are combined, create the new variable. That new variable name is the seniority level. So the seniority level is a new feature is created by combining the two correlated features. So this new feature is be dependent on the other two independent variables. So that is the case. This is the example. So creating the variable for seniority level from the age and years of experience variable would include the redundant information in this model. So include the identical variables in the dataset. For example, temperature is one of the feature in your dataset. So temperature in Fahrenheit and temperature in Celsius, they are the two independent variables if you consider in the dataset. So these two input variables will give the same kind of information about the temperature. So temperature in Fahrenheit, temperature in Celsius, both are the same kind of identical features. So due to identical features, they may multiply be occur. So inaccurate use of the dummy variables can also cause the multicollinearity. This problem is known as the dummy variable trap. For example, there is one of the feature name is marriage. Marriage is one of the feature. So under the marriage, there is the two labels, either the person having marriage or not, which means single or married. So at that moment of time, if you are supposed to create the dummy variables, two dummy variables, so it may be redundant information. That's why we have to use any one of the variable for the building model. So if you use the two variables, you will get the redundant information, then you are supposed to get the, you will have the multicollinearity. So one more kind of thing is that insufficient data in some cases can also cause the multicollinearity problems. So next one is the Pearson correlation. So a Pearson correlation is a number between the minus 1 and plus 1. So that indicates the extent to which two variables are linearly related. The Pearson correlation is also known as the product moment correlation coefficient, PMCC, which is simply called the correlation. So the correlation coefficient has the values between the minus 1 to plus 1. Suppose the value closer to 0, weak correlation. If it is closer to plus 1, strong positive correlation. If closer to minus 1, strong negative correlation. So this is my sample data set. X1, X2, X3, X4, these are the four independent variables, and Y is my target variable. So from this diagram, the correlation matrix, if you observe, among the independent variables. So here X1 is the correlated with X1, 1. X2 is correlated with the feature X2, 1. Which means that the correlation between the, among the same feature, always 1. From this correlation matrix, you can observe the correlation X1 between the X1 X3 is 0.90, which is highly correlated. So compared to X1 to X4, here X1 to X4 is 0.16, X1 to X2 0.077. So which means there is a high correlated features are the X1 X3, that is the 0.90. The same kind of information can be visualized through the heat map. So this is the correlation matrix between the independent variables and derivative variable. So the heat map is also the same thing like between the independent variables and derivative variable. So here from this correlation matrix, you can observe the strong correlation, weak correlation. So next one, how do we detect and remove the multicollinearity? I want to know the one input variable X1 is related to the all other remaining input variables X2, X3. For example, in our data set, if there is a normal correlation. So normal correlation looks like X1 to X2, X2 to X3, X3 to X4, X1 to X4 like that. So these two variables at a time. But I want to know how X1 variable is related to the all other remaining variables X2, X3, X4. So how can I do that? So in this case, we can use the VIF. So VF is the best way to identify the multicollinearity to calculate the variance influence factor corresponding to every independent variables in the data set, which means we have to calculate the VF score for every independent variables. So which means that VIF determines the strength of the correlation between the independent variables. So VF score of independent variables represent how well the variable is explained by other independent variables. So that is the main important point, which means that the VF score of the independent variable X1, which represents how well the variable is explained by the other independent variables X2, X3, X4. So how to calculate? So here in this example, if you understand clearly, there are the four input features X1, X2, X3, X4. So among the four independent features, actually our data contain the four independent features X1, X2, X3, X4 and Y. Y is the target variable. So for calculating the VF score for independent variables, so we no need to take the target variable Y. We need to consider only independent variables, all independent variables. So from our data set, four independent variables are existent: X1, X2, X3, X4. That's why I taken all independent variables X1, X2, X3, X4. So from these four independent variables, first I had to isolate the X1 variable separate and consider as my target variable, and the remaining three variables X2, X3, X4 consider as my independent variables. So these three independent variables and this target variable X1, by using these four features, we can build the regression model. So building the regression model, fit the regression model, find the R-square value. Find the R-square value and take the R-square value and put it into this VIF formula and calculate the VIF score for the feature X1. So calculate the VIF for the feature X1. And similarly, next time, what will you do? Next time, X2 variable will be keep it separate, isolate, consider the target variable. And the remaining features X1, X3, X4, these three features will be considered as the independent variables. And fit the regression model and calculate the R-square value, substitute it to the VIF formula, and you will get the VIF score for the X2 variable. So next time, you can isolate the X3 variable, consider as a target variable, and remaining X1, X2, X4, consider the independent variables, calculate the R-square value, and substitute VIF error. So in the same way, so X4 also. So that is the procedure to calculate the VIF score for the every independent variables. So if R-square value signifies that the target independent variable is very well explained by the other independent variables. That is the meaning. So a R-square value is determined to find out how well an independent variable is described by the other independent variables. So a high value of R-square means that the variable is highly correlated with the other variables. So the VIF formula is 1 by 1 minus R-square. So VIF tells us how well independent variables are predictable by using the independent variables. So now what should I do? So VIF threshold value is decided whether the variable should be removed or not. So among the four features, which feature I should be considered, which feature I should be removed. So based on the VIF score, I can decide. Suppose if the VIF value is equal to 5 or greater than 5, suppose VIF value is equal to 5, consider as my threshold value. So the VIF score value of the feature is greater than 5, so those feature has to be dropped it from the table. So if VIF value starts with 1, but there is no upper limit. If VIF value 1, no correlation between independent variables. If VIF value exceeds 5 or 10, high multicollinearity between these independent variables and other variables. Some researchers assume VIF is greater than 5, and some researchers assume VIF is greater than 10. So it depends on the person to person, and it depends on the problem statement. People may decide the threshold value 5 or 10. variance influence factor, if is 1, no multicollinearity, less than 5, low multicollinearity or moderately correlated, greater than 5, high multicollinearity, which means that VF value is high multicollinearity, VA value is low, like 1 to below 5, is low multicollinearity. Suppose in this table 1, if you consider all independent variables have the multicollinearity, VF score is x1 variable 12.17, x2 variable VF score 1.14, x3 variable 10.58, x3 feature 1.53. So among the four features, the x1 feature has the more VF value. That's why I have to drop the x1 feature from the independent variable. Again, apply the VF value, you can get the output like table 2. So this is the case. So dropping the variable should be iterative process, which means the first time in this table 1, I drop this x1 from the independent variable x, then calculate the VF value, you will get the result will be in table 2. Suppose in this result table, in the table 2, the all VF values are less than 5, which means there is no multicollinearity. Suppose in this table 2, any VF value is greater than 5, which suppose x4 feature here 1.35, but if x4 is 7 point something, so next time you have to remove the x4 feature from the table 2. So every time you have to remove the one feature at a time, and again apply the VF and check the VF score. If it exceeds the threshold value, drop it. So this is an iterative process. So next kind of approach is combine the correlated variables into one new variable. So this here, combine the correlated variables x1, x3. This is x1, x3. Why should I combine this to x1, x3? If you observe here, so here the x1 feature is correlated with x3 is 0.90, which means x1, x3, these two features are highly correlated. That's why this x1, x3 combined create the new feature x5, and after combining x5 and drop this x1, x3 from the table, you will get the result table looking like this. So this is the way you can create the new kind of feature from combining the two features. So what is the solutions for multicollinearity? So remove the collinear dependent variable is the simple method for solving the multicollinearity. And next kind of approach is the ridge and lasso. Suppose your data set is very small, means very less number of features, then at that moment of time, drop the one of the correlated feature, you can build the model, then no issue. But if it is more than 100 features are there in your data set, so at that time, you can suppose to apply the advanced techniques like ridge regression, lasso regression. You can penalize this, penalize this coefficients. So I clearly explain about this ridge regression, lasso regression in my previous lectures. Please go and watch it. And next step is the increase the sample size may sometimes solve the problem of multicollinearity. So if you go to the practical section, you can clearly understand about the topic very well. First, let me import the require libraries. So data set. So I will show you my data set. So this is my sample data set. So x1, x2, x3, x4, these are four input features. Y is my target variable. I am taking the sixth rows of the data, sample data. So if you see here, this is my total data set. X1, x2, x3, x4, these are four input features. Y is my target variable. So I separate my independent variable, dependent variable. So this is my x and this is my y. So let me check the correlation. So this is my correlation matrix. So in this correlation matrix, you can observe here from x1 to x3, this is 0.88, which means this is the x1, x3 highly correlated. So you can observe the same kind of result through the heat map. So now I am going to apply the variance influence factor. So if you calculate the VF value, so VF value for x1 is 13.95. So are you clearly explain how to calculate the VIF for this variable x1? Suppose I am taking the four input features x1, x2, x3, x4. So first initially I separate the x1 and consider as my target variable. Now remaining three x2, x3, x4 consider independent variables and build the regression model, calculate the R square value, put it into a VF formula. You will get the VF score for this input feature. So next time you can separate the x2 feature from the four features and consider x2 feature as a target variable and consider x1, x3, x4, consider the independent variables, build the regression model, calculate the R square value and substitute in VF formula, you will get the R square value. Similarly, you will get the x3, x4. So in this table, this is the highest VF score for the x1 variable. That's why I have to drop the x1 variable. So before drop the x1 variable, first let me check the x values. So if in x values, under the x values, x1, x2, x3, x4, there are the four input features are existed. So from this independent variables, I don't want this x1 variable. That's why I have to drop this x1 variable and the result will be put it in same x itself. So that's why this time the x independent variable is x2, x3, x4 only. So now again apply the VIF. Now this time VIF is the, you know, before x3 it is 10.82. So again apply the VIF after dropping the x1 on this table, you will get the VIF x3 is 1.13, it means reduced. So in this way you can calculate the VIF score for each individual feature. And one more approach is you have to combine. So combine the correlated features variables into one new variable. So combine the correlated variables x1, x3 and create the x5 variable. So this is my data frame. So in this data frame I have to combine this x1 and x3 and create the new feature. So that's why I separated first to x and y. This is my x. So in this x, first let me calculate the VF score. So x1, x2, x3, x4. So this is the highest x1 VF score value. That's why I have to drop the. So in this case, what I'm doing, I have to combine this x1 feature and x3 feature. Why should I combine x1 and x3? Because in this heat map, in this map, so x1 with x3 with highly correlated with 0.88. That's why this x1, x3, these two features are highly correlated. These three features are combined. Combined in the sense in the form of multiplication operations. And you will create the new feature that is nothing but the x5. So if you understand how this x2 value came, which means x1 here, x1 is multiplied with x3, which means x1 value, x3 values are multiplied. So 2 is multiplied with 1, the result will be 2. So 3 is multiplied with 5, result will be 15. So 5 is multiplied with 20, the result will be 100. So in this way, you will get the x5 value. Now let's check this DF value. So x5 new feature is added to this previously data frame. So after creating new data frame, I don't want this x1 and x3 and y. I don't want. That's why I draw these three features, two independent variables and target variable. And now my updated x value will be x2, x4 and x5. From this table, I supposed to apply the VIF and calculate the VF score. So this time every feature VF score will be less than 5. So this is the way you can combine these two highly correlated features and create the new feature. So this is the practical section. So I'm giving the summary. So if one input variable x1 is related to other input variables, other remaining variables x2, x3, x4. So at that point, at that moment of time, vf is applying. Through vf we can calculate the vf score for every individual element and identify the which is highly correlated. So threshold value is 5 or 10, depends on the data, depends on the problem statement. People may choose either 5 or 10. So this is the case about the multicollinearity. So this is the some references regarding this previous lecture. I hope you understand this lecture. If you have any comments or doubts, please make it in comment section. Thank you.